the best trampolines to buy?
What are the worst trampolines to buy? 2017, just this year, that's it when I'm filming it. The reason I'm filming this video, aside from the fact that I need a video and because I have a few things I want to talk about, is because this is a question I get a lot and something that makes me a qualified person to talk about it is, well, I hope you guys know this, but if you don't, we have like four and a half trampolines. I don't really know if you count that one.
Did I tell you I spray painted it black for an Amazon like promotional video? And I'm too lazy to put the cover back on it.
But anyways, I'm gonna be doing like a sit down video, but I'm outside, so it's a little bit better than me sitting in the basement. Talking about the best stuff to buy, a little bit of action, like me doing stuff. So, cause like this is what I do. I mean, I also dive. This is kind of my main thing now. I'm on the national team. No big deal. But before I get into the video, the mega reason that I'm skipping dive to actually film this, I shouldn't really be skipping it, is we got new merch. I finally came up with some new merch. It took me a long time to put together. I don't know why it took so long, but it's something that you guys are gonna love, and I can't wait for it to go live and for you guys to get it while you can. I believe I'm launching it for 2 weeks. We got like IDK 6 shirts, hoodies, and pizza socks, because a lot of you guys know that I have pizza shoes.
I'm sorry, I'm not wearing my pizza shoes right now.
But those shoes, actually, you know what? I'm gonna go show you guys.
These shoes.
It's like the exact same design, but on one sock it says GM, like a signature type of thing. And on the other sock it says, I don't know, 6. I'm sorry they're not trampoline socks. That's making trampoline socks and selling them. Making them and ordering them, that's the really hard part. But I promise you guys, at some point we're gonna get the trampoline socks. So get it while you can. That's a little bit cheaper than what I did the last time because people were complaining that it was a little expensive. And I take that into consideration. I just go buy it. Click the link in the description down below. Go get you some Gavin May merch. Second line of merch. It's really good. I actually really like this stuff. My first line, it was all right. Like, it wasn't bad. I don't really wear it that often, but this stuff, I'm gonna wear a lot. It's really good. Get it. Get it right now. Now that we're done with the plugging merch part of the video, let's get into best trampolines to buy, worst trampolines to buy. A lot of the trampolines I have, I like a lot. So as you might imagine, I'm gonna recommend some of the ones that I have. Let me get my tripod so I can look more professional. Look at that, we look professional. We got one trampoline, 2, 3, and there's one right here and one over there. So for those of you guys who don't know this, the one that I'm sitting on right now, this is like a really, really old spring free trampoline. The thing about spring frees are, they're all right. They're really not that bad. The thing about this one is it's really old. It's lower to the ground than the newer ones are. So if you want to like get it to do tricks, definitely get a newer one. The newer ones I've been on, they're not that bad. The thing about them though, is you take a lot of energy to like actually get high on, like jump high, not, yeah, you know what I mean. But they're like extremely expensive. I'll put a screenshot up on the screen right here. It's a lot. Like, I think it's like 2,000 plus or something ridiculous. That's for doing tricks. The thing about spring frees though, they're like the safest trampoline you can possibly get. Kind of why my mom got me this trampoline in the first place. I got it when I was in like second grade. This is the first trampoline I ever got that kickstarted my trampoline career. They're really safe if you have the net on it. As you can see, I don't have the net off. I took it off for a video like exactly a year ago, back when it was where the skybone is right now. And I just kept it off ever since because I'm just lazy. And it's better for the yard. But that's my opinion on the spring free. I'll give you a jump test right now, I guess. Keep in mind, I am most likely gonna bottom out. Oh, there's the bottom out. You can get decently high, but for the price and if you're looking to do tricks on it, definitely would not really recommend it. Unless you're a parent and safety is like your number one priority, then yeah, get this one. Second trampoline I'm gonna be talking about is the Skybound Stratos. This is a 15-foot Stratos, which is the biggest Stratos they offer. For those of you who don't know, I'm actually sponsored by Skybound, so I was fortunate enough to receive this trampoline and the Orion for free. Super grateful for that. They're both really amazing trampolines. Couple of good things about the Stratos. For a circle, it's fairly priced, I'll put it that way, because I'm pretty sure as of right now there's a sale going on. MSRP is like 800, I think. But I have the upgraded springs and the legs, which means a little bit taller, a little bit bouncier. For people like me who like to train on trampoline, or I guess used to train, I don't really do this much, but makes the trampoline a lot bouncier for sure. And if you guys are interested in getting a Skybound trampoline, I do have a code for you guys. So you will save 10% if you use it. Go down in the description, you'll find it. If you go to the Skybound website, put in the code Gavin10 upon checkout, you'll receive 10% off. So that may give you an incentive to get a Skybound. Another important thing about it that like is important when considering trampolines to buy is the setup. Oh my God, the setup was so easy. Like, it took me and I think like one other friend or two other friends, I don't remember. It literally took us like 20-30 minutes to build. It's so easy, really simple, no screwing in at all, which is another really nice thing. It comes with a net and a spring pad, both of which I don't have on because that's really not how I roll. I'll give you a height test though. And no, I do not bottom out on this one because it is raised a little bit. Before I got the leg extension, just about the same height as the spring free, so it definitely got like 6 inches taller, give or take. Height test. Boo. When it's wet, I can get a little bit higher. I'm also tired, it's pretty cold out.
Quality.
But with double balance, it's also, it's nice, it's pretty good. Onward to the rectangle trampoline. You'll want to have the Akon AirSport 16. I'll talk about it from right here so you can still see the trampoline in the background. The Akon AirSport 16, or just the Akon rectangle, as people will call it, because it's a rectangle and it's made by Akon. Obviously, it does come with a net. You can see the poles I have on it. I just took it off. I made a video on that if you guys want to watch it. Out of all the trampolines I have, it is the bouncy one I have because it's a rectangle. Rectangles are just naturally bouncier, which I guess is something to consider if you're thinking about buying a trampoline. Safety wise, Spring Free is a little safer. Skybound Strata is probably a little bit safer too, just because it's a circle. And the way the enclosure is made, it's kind of hard to explain, but on the Akon, like, it straps around the pole. So picture those poles here. Actually, if I have a clip of the net, I'll put it up right here.
Yes!
The net is on the outside of the trampoline, which means you can still fall through it. Like, I've fallen through it so many times. That doesn't matter to me because I can control myself. I know where I am. I know how to make it not hurt. But if you guys don't know how to, like, control yourself in the air, or you get hurt easily, or you're a parent and you're kind of worried about your kids hurting yourself, I wouldn't really go with that. The Skybound Stratos is nice for that type of stuff. And then if they like start doing more tricks, you can get the upgrade kit, you know, make it a little better. I believe the MSRP on the Akon rectangle is like $1,600 or $1,700. I got it for $17, like a little over a year ago. It was my first like really good trampoline that I had, and it still is like my better one. But one of the biggest problems I had with it, which is why I don't like it that much, is I would bottom out, and let me show you why. The thing that Akon did differently when compared to other trampolines is the legs go underneath it as opposed to on the sides like this one and basically all my other ones. So if you were like me and you like weigh a decent amount and you have enough power to get high on the trampoline, you would literally smash that bar every single time. I've taken measures to avoid that, such as double crossing the springs, and I made a bunch of other videos on that type of stuff. So if you guys want to click here or here, I made a video on when I double crossed it. It does make a bounce here, but a big problem with that is that the springs break a lot faster. Doesn't matter to me because I couldn't care less. But take that into consideration when you're deciding what to buy. Assembly, oh my, the assembly was another really big downside to the Akon rectangle. It took us like 4 or 5 hours to build. Like half of the stuff wasn't even in English. I mean, it was English, but it was hard to read. Like it wasn't direct at all. So a lot of screwing in, we screwed a lot of the wrong stuff in. Might've been our fault, but I'm pretty sure if you ask anyone else who has this trampoline, like they would say the same thing. The least amount of time it would take you to build would be like 2 hours, which I guess is expected when you buy a high-end trampoline, but still, it's not preferable at all when it comes to building. Okay, on to next trampoline that we have.
Skybound Orion.
Now, the interesting thing about the Orion is, this is like, I don't know if this is true or not, but I'm pretty sure it's like the first production oval trampoline ever to be put into production. I said production twice.
But as you can see, this is an oval. It's 11 by 16. The Akon is 9 by 16. That's 15 foot circle, and this is like 12 or 13. But you can see, obviously, it's an oval. Take a bite of me, bite of me.
Upsides and a lot of downside to it being an oval. First of all though, like I said, I do have a Skybound discount code for you guys. So if you guys are interested in getting an Orion, which I do recommend, and I'll explain to you in a second. Same idea with the Stratos, just go to skyboundusa.com, type in my code, or click the link in my description down below and then type in the code. You'll get 10% off the Orion. This is the 11 by 16 model, so I believe the price is like $1,400 or $1,500. I can't remember off the top of my head. The legs are already like the same height as the Akon, which means like bottoming out is not gonna be a problem at all. The net is on the inside. It's kind of hard to explain that without having the net on it, but basically like it's safer. But another interesting thing, which is, I don't really know if I agree with it or not, but it's just something I would state.
It does come with spring pads. I don't have spring pads on any of my trampolines, but the thing about the Orion mat, it actually covers the springs. This one, that part's folded, but like if you look at it, it covers the springs.
That doesn't really affect your bounce, like to my knowledge, but it has a weird feel to it, like it being an oval. It's a different type of bounce. It's not bad, it's not necessarily bad versus good. It's just different. It takes a little bit of getting used to, but I love it. I really do enjoy it. Assembly is really similar to the Skybound Stratos. It's super simple. It took me like literally 20 or 30 minutes to build with one of my good friends who also knows a lot about trampolines. He has 4 as well. I can get a little bit higher than I can on here than I can on the Stratos, which is a circle. So those are the 4 trampolines that I have minus the Akon circle. circle, the Akon Mini, just like a small circle trampoline I got for fun. I'm gonna recommend to you guys a few different types of trampolines that I've been on or have used that I enjoy, or not necessarily enjoy, but I think are reasonable for people maybe on a budget or aren't appealed to the ones that I've mentioned so far. My dad has a Skywalker Rectangle, which is like 15 by 9. The bounce is nowhere near as good as the Akon or any of the trampolines I have. It's also a lot cheaper. I don't know what assembly was like. He told me it wasn't the best thing in the world. If I have a clip, I'll play it, and if not, I'll put a clip of it on screen right here. It's not the best trampoline in the world. Not the worst trampoline in the world either. Like, there are plenty of worse ones if you go to Walmart and get a trampoline for like 200 bucks. If you want bounce, you're not gonna be happy with it. If you're a parent or anyone wanting to buy their kids or someone you know a trampoline, I guess Walmart's like okay. I've been on like one, but like comparing that to any of the stuff that I have, it's definitely a no-go for me. It's got like a rectangle. It's like $700, I think. You can get decent bounce on it. The net, it goes on the inside. Akon Air 4.3 and 4.6. Those are the Akon circles. I've been on a 4.6. I haven't been on a 4.3. The thing I remember about the 4.6 was that it was so tight, like painfully tight.
He probably shouldn't have done that.
I couldn't get incredibly high. I know some people that have done some really nice stuff, some really cool stuff on it. I'm not one of those people. I'm not a fan of it, honestly. It's just really tight. I would imagine assembly would not be incredibly easy because the rectangle was like the worst thing to build ever. In terms of safety, obviously it's pretty safe. It's a circle, a little safer than the rectangle. Spring pad comes standard with like every trampoline it does. The net is the same idea as the other one. Like, it goes on the outside. If you're a little confused by what I mean by that, basically with this trampoline, the net would be like, it would go onto the inside and there'd be no way you could crawl out. I mean, I guess you could, but like, you would need to force it. With the Akon, you could literally, if you shoot towards the side, you're gonna fall out. Like, 90% of the time, you're gonna fall out. So I guess take that into consideration. I don't know the price of the Akon Air 4.3 and 4.6 off the top of my head. 4.3 and 4.6 is the size of the trampoline in meters, so it's 14 feet and 15 feet. If I'm not mistaken, that should be about right. For those, like, willing to spend a lot of money and you want a good trampoline, a relatively safe trampoline, hard to build from what I've heard, Alley-Oop or Jump Sport, they make. I'm a huge fan of their product. I've been on it a few times. I've done like really good stuff on there, or at the time was good. Now it's not really. I'll cue a few clips of them if I have them. But the thing about that trampoline is that rectangle is like $3,000 or $2,750 or something ridiculous. So if you want to spend that, like, go ahead, I guess. I'm not gonna try and stop you. It's a great trampoline, but just like keep in mind, building it is an incredibly long process. The net is even more complicated because like you have to like spiral it around. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just a really long process. And for those of you who don't live in the US and you live in like any other country, I know a trampoline brand in Australia. My friend is actually sponsored by them. His name is Jesse. He's sponsored by a trampoline company called Web and Warehouse. I don't really know the price of the trampoline. I don't really know much about it at all, but I just thought I'd mention that because this is what their trampoline looks like. They have a lot of different models they make. They make a square one, which is interesting because I've never been on a square besides the Super Tramp. Then they make rectangles too. According to him though, the trampoline's really nice. He has a rectangle. He's done some pretty nice stuff on it. And then in Europe, there's a trampoline company called North Trampoline. I don't know much about it. I've never been on one. I've only been to Europe like twice or one, I don't even know. But I would assume they're nice trampolines. I've seen people do stuff on them. Safety wise, I would assume they're safe. Actually no, they make an oval too. They make Skybound and North make oval trampolines. I don't know anything about assembly or any of that stuff or even prices. I'm pretty sure that covers basically any trampoline I would recommend buying or not recommend buying. If you want safe, go with the Spring Free or the Skybound. Skybound does a really good job, like, because they take safety into a lot of consideration. No, they're not paying me or telling me to say this. I'm just saying this because I have two of their products and I've loved them forever. I've never really hurt myself bad ever on a trampoline. All trampolines do a decent job of keeping safety in mind. Some do a better job than others. Let's just put it that way. If you have any questions regarding like nets and like safety pads or any of that stuff, comment down below. I'll try to get back to you about it. Price is also an important thing to consider when you're thinking about buying one. The ones I have are priced anywhere from like, I mean, if you exclude the mini trampoline, anywhere from like 800 to 2000. Like, these are high-end trampolines. And then assembly is also a big part of it. The Skybounds were really easy to assemble. Akon was not. I'm sure Springfree was horrible to build. I didn't build it. I was maybe like 8 or 9. I don't know about Skywalker. I don't know about Walmart or any of the other trampolines. I don't have them. Obviously, I don't. I will put an edit up on screen right here of what I'm able to do on the Akon Rectangle and Skybound Orion. I'm hoping the song isn't copyrighted. Back and wrap it up for today's video. Sorry about it being a little bit on the longer side. Talking and like recommending you the trampolines that I have, what I recommend buying, what I've been on. It's also requested. Speaking of requested though, I request that you guys click the link in my description, get you guys some I Don't Know Six merch because you won't regret it and I will love you. And if you post a picture that I'll like it, maybe put it on my story, shout you out, you know, all that good stuff. But I'm gonna shut up. This video is just about over. Don't forget, I do have a Skybound discount code. So if you guys do end up getting a Skybound, make sure to use Gavin10 upon checkout. Receive 10% off. But I'm gonna stop talking. If you guys stuck at the end of today's video, you're awesome. I really appreciate it. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe if you're new, as well. Thank you for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out. I don't know.